Anything we do in the table filters, whether they are permanent or retrievable types, are designed to be left in the patient for a long time. The construction of the filter is made out of stainless steel or some kind of metal alloy that is designed to withstand years of being inside the human body. Occasionally, though, those filters can have problems. The three main problems that we see with filters is that the filter itself can develop blood clots in it and block the main vein, the IVC. This can lead to significant swelling and pain in the lower extremities. Also, the filters themselves being made out of metal, over time, the metal can stress or fatigue. The filter can break. Pieces of the filter can migrate into the patient and damage adjacent organs or structures. And very rarely, pieces of the filter can actually break off and go to the heart and the lungs. While these complications are extremely uncommon, it is a source of patient anxiety, and we often receive a number of phone calls. Some patients asking whether or not their filter needs to be removed to avoid these complications. In 2010, the FDA recommended that physicians who place these filters and physicians who follow patients with these filters make an attempt to consider filter retrieval in patients with IVC filters when that filter is no longer needed. Sometimes that's a tough question to answer because we don't necessarily know which patients are best suited to have a filter in for the rest of their lives. So when a patient calls our office and says, hey, I have an empty venous over filter and I would like to get it removed, what we typically do is have that patient come in, have a consultation, discuss why they have a filter placed in the first place, and try to make an informed decision about whether retrieval is appropriate for them or not. Sometimes it's a very easy question to answer. Sometimes we need to do additional tests and consult with other physicians before making that decision.